What's up, YouTube? RenaM97. I'm on a roll with these videos today. Got off from work, so I decided, why not just make a whole gang of videos and upload them? So my video right before this one was focusing on one of my beloved shoes, the Nike Air Griffey Max 1. And now I am moving on to like another, I would say this is probably my, definitely a top five shoe as well. I just don't know exactly where to place them. And this is actually the one I'm going to show you. This is my first one of these shoes. They're kind of beat, but I still love them. Trying to, you know, like, you know, they're kind of falling apart a little bit and all that, like some soul separation, but I still wear them. But here we go. The Royal Foamposite 1 Penny Hardaway signature shoe. I love this shoe. This one is actually the original pair from 97. Lucked out on Craigslist. I got this like right before. It was crazy. I bought these right before they released the next few pairs, I feel like, and it was 09. And I paid like $135 for them. And I love these. I love this shoe. Like, I want another OG pair. Like, the other ones, I feel like the blue is kind of dull and the shape is a little different. These are size 8 and they look small. I don't know. I had to touch up the suede a bit with some paint. The suede is cracking. I don't know if you can really see. Well, it was cracking, but after I sprayed it with the suede renew, you can't really tell, and that's the whole point. Like, these actually, they look pretty good. Got some paint chips. If anybody knows how to repaint like the blue on the Foamposite here, or where I can buy paint that matches exactly, let me know, because I think if I could just touch that up, I'll be good with these, and of course have somebody re-glue the soles. Okay, but it's not about that shoe. Oh, it is about that shoe. I'm rambling. Just give me a moment to collect my thoughts. Okay, it's about Foamposites in general. It's like, I feel like I've been on different sites, so I'm a lurker on Nike Talk. I lurk on Soul Collector. And it seems like there's kind of like this split between people at Foamposites. There are people who are like, I just want the solid colorways, like this. The solid, basic colorways, the shoe, the silhouette itself, the design, it speaks for itself. Then there are the people who don't mind, you know, the prints. You know, I feel like the first printed shoe was the Galaxy, right? Correct me if I'm wrong. The Galaxy was the first printed shoe. And we all know how that worked out for me, so I don't have them. But ever since then, it's like, okay, Nike saw how people responded to that. Then they came out with the Paranormans, and people just love that shoe. So Nike was like, let's take it a step forward. Let's do these. Now, when I first saw this shoe, I was like, ugh, too much, right? But when I saw the shoe in person, like actually on people's feet, and then I just started thinking about what I could do with this shoe, I was like, it's not that bad. And I, you know, I walked in the DMV. I walked in 2 weeks after this release, went to Foot Locker. I was like, I'm going to ask a stupid question, but do you have any of these left? And she was like, oh, we got a whole rack. And I was like, a whole rack? I was like, do you have a 7.5? And she was like, yeah, we got a whole lot of them. Like, nobody bought them. So I did. And this shoe has grown on me immensely. I really like it. I just like the colors. I like the silver, the gray, the black, white. I like the print. I like this checkerboard carbon fiber. I don't really mind this print. You know, I think this is a clean shoe. But they didn't just stop there. They got the Army Camel ones, which I did buy. I'm just waiting for it to come in the mail, which is another shoe I love because I love that gum sole. But then after that, they didn't stop there. They hit us with the Weathermans. So I'm going to insert a picture real quick. Okay. So the Weathermans was like, I like the laces. I kind of like the blue around it. And I like the sole, I like the translucent blue, that shift, but I don't like the pattern on it. You know, I'm like, they could have done a lot better. And why rip off a Nike shoe already? Like, think of something. Yeah, so the Weatherman's pretty much a rip off of the KD shoe. They think, okay, everybody went crazy for the KD Weathermans. People are going to go crazy for these Weatherman Foamposites. And while I like the colors on the Weatherman, Foamposite. I just don't like the design at all. So then, after they got such horrible reviews from that, they bring up this. They bring up, what is it called? The thermal map. The thermal map foamposites. These all white foamposites with these red heat, thermal heat map. That's what it is. These heat blotches, these red blotches on it. And there are so many things that this shoe has been called. It's been called the tampon foamposites, the maxi pads. They've said that they resemble, you know, and these are other people's words, they resemble AIDS, which is a bit insensitive. It's just, I mean, the shoe just, it looks like an STD. People have said it looks like an STD. It's horrible. It's just straight horrible. And I love foamposites. You know, I like foamposites when other people don't even like them. Like, people probably think I'm a hype beast for buying these. I buy what I like, but I feel like they just... Like, who literally looked at that shoe? Because it's not like it's just a drawing of it. It's an actual shoe. Like, somebody went through with it, took pictures of it, said, yo, that looks hot. Then leaked it to all of these blog sites, these sneaker sites, and said, hey, put this picture up. We're going to release it. This shoe has a release date. That means they actually intend on going forward with it. And my first reaction when I saw it was, is this a joke? And then my next reaction, before I even saw that it was called a tampon pad, tampon foam, I was like, it looks like somebody's menstrual cycle. It looks like blood. It looks like chopped up bunnies. You know, it looks like blood. It looks like blotchy blood. It looks like some shit people cough up, you know, when they're sick. It looks like diphtheria or malaria or some hacking, coughing, typhoid fever, tuberculosis. That's what it looks like. It looks like an illness. People are gonna walk around with illness on your feet. So this is the question I bring to you. What do you guys feel about this shoe? So you obviously know how I feel. And like I said, you're entitled to your opinion. If you like them, you like them. Just, you know, let me know. I don't. And I hope they don't cost $250 like the Army Camel ones, because, like, I just don't see it happening. Do you think the shoe is gonna sit? Do you think it's actually gonna release? Do you think Nike might backtrack and be like, whoa, let's make some changes? Do you think this is really the final version of the shoe? What do you think about, like, you know, the direction that foamposites are going into? What side are you on? I know I'm asking a lot of questions. Are you on the let's just keep it plain and simple, do solid colorways, maybe, you know, different upper, different sole type of thing, or maybe even mix up the carbon fiber plates? Or are you on the, okay, patterns are fine, that this one is good, or patterns are fine, but just as long as they're good patterns? I'm definitely on the side of patterns are fine, as long as it's a good pattern and it complements the shoe. You know, I feel like with these blotchy ones, you can't even see the foamposite shape. Like with this, you can at least see the foamposite shape. Like the Weathermans, they make the shoe look flat and just, I don't know, with so much going on, I don't know how they managed to make a shoe look so basic. And I know that sounds like a big contradiction, but that's how I feel. So let me know what you think about, you know, these foamposites releasing. Let me know, are you going to buy any foamposites? Do you think foamposites are dead? Do you think they're overdone? Do you think they're just getting started? Like, just let me know. So comment, subscribe, let me know how you feel. I want your honest opinion. I don't care if you disagree with me. It's okay. I actually want you to disagree with me, because that's going to make it interesting. So, all right, I'm Rena M87. Peace.